I'm Matt and I play guitar and sing.
I'm Pete, I do the same.
I'm Scott, I play bass.
And do a bit of singing sometimes.
Occasionally I do a bit of singing when I feel like it.
Call it that.
High-pitched wailing.
Yeah, I noticed on some of your YouTube comments that they were like, people were like, how does that voice come out of that hairy man? I don't know.
I can't answer that, I have no idea. No. It just sort of happened.
A lot of people were admiring this and I really want to touch it.
You can touch it, yeah.
I'm going to drop straight into album things. Because your debut album comes out pretty damn soon.
Yeah.
Are you nervous? Excited?
Really excited. We're glad to get it out because we finished it like the end of last summer.
Yeah.
So we've kind of been sat on it without it being released for a long time.
Has there been a lot of preparation in kind of the lead up to the album?
Definitely, yeah. We've been doing a load of like press stuff and, you know, trying to get people to know about it. We've done these listening party things where we took the album up to show it to some fans and stuff like that. And so far, the reaction that I've heard has all been reasonably okay.
Yeah, no one said it's the worst thing ever.
No, that's good. Because there's always haters out there.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll find some sooner or later. Oh, yeah.
But you've managed to play a ridiculous amount of gigs and you haven't even released an album yet, so that must feel really good to be able to get music out there beforehand.
Yeah, I think now for the first time we'll be doing shows to people who've heard our music on record, which is a novelty for us.
Yeah.
So you'll have people singing along even more?
Could be, yeah.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Oh. So for the people that haven't seen you before and, you know, they might be listening to your album for the first time, do you feel like it kind of tells a lot about you as people?
Yeah, I guess. Well, I think it says a lot about our sort of genesis as a band, like the fact that we, you know, like kind of shows how we've arrived at where we're going. I think there's like, you know, it sort of runs the gamut from very acoustic kind of folkier stuff to some pretty epic sort of heavier stuff. And so it kind of showcases the various elements of our sort of musicianship, I guess, and like how we arrived at
where you are now.
Dry the River sounding the way it does and stuff. So yeah, I guess it kind of is a nice across the board sort of cross section of our influences and our kind of music to date. It's kind of cool.
Oh, good. And you recorded a lot of the album to tape, didn't you? Because you wanted the analogue sound right over the digital. Why did you, obviously it sounds amazing and you can tell the difference, but why did you decide to do that? Because it sometimes can be quite a lengthy process.
Peter just sort of does it as a matter of course, I think, anyway, like the producer, so that was part of it. And yeah, it sounded great. He had the facilities to do it, and I think he's, you know, he's a dying breed, the people who still use tape. But yeah, it sounded.
Is that why you chose him then? Because you were like, this guy can do it for us.
He just seemed like he was the real deal, yeah.
Yeah.
And he had such an awesome studio and stuff. So. Mm.
We liked like all the records he's done previously,
yeah.
Like the way they sound. So yeah, it was awesome working with him.
And do you think you'll be putting some maybe onto vinyl in the future, so people can hear that crackle and?
The record's coming out on vinyl. Actually,
is it?
It's like a special edition, double vinyl of the album. We just got to see them for the first time the other day. They look pretty cool.